Hi, this is Dr. Subhatra. In this session, I am going to discuss about the runway orientation. What is a runway? It is a rectangular area which is provided in the aerodrome used for landing and takeoff of an aircraft. This orientation is very important in airport planning. Usually, how we'll go for a runway orientation is by considering the wind force. In the direction of the prevailing wind, we'll try to lay out our runway. So, direction of runway will control, will decide about the other facilities where each and every one has to be located. So, as I said, orientation of runway depends upon the direction of wind and also on how much area is available for the development, future development also. A runway is oriented in the direction of the prevailing wind. It is a very critical task to determine the orientation of a runway. Okay. Then what are the data required for this runway orientation? We need the map or the contour area of the runway to determine how far the area is flat or not. To look into the profile of the land, we need the contour details and the area map. Then the next detail what we need is a wind data. The direction, duration and intensity of wind is required for about 5 to 10 years. We can get that from the meteorological department. It will be keeping on, it will keep on changing day by day, month by month and year by year also. What are the different types of wind? One is a headwind, second one is a tailwind, next is a crosswind. Among these three, headwind is a very favorable wind for our aircraft and for the runway orientation also. It is a headwind is a wind which is blowing from opposite direction of the head or nose of the aircraft. See here, this one, this mid diagram, this is the head or nose of an aircraft. The wind blowing in an opposite direction to the head of the aircraft, we'll call it as a headwind. This headwind will decrease the length of runway by around 10% because it provides a braking effect during the landing and it gives a greater lift on the wings during takeoff. So our supporting wind, the according to us, a very good wind is a headwind. The next, coming to the tailwind. The wind is blown in the same direction on the aircraft. See here, aircraft is blowing in the same direction. Both the blue color and the red color arrow is pointing in the same direction. So it is moving along the same direction of the aircraft. It increases the wind. When the wind is also blowing in the same direction, the stopping distance has to be increased and liftoff distance will also be greater. It is a very dangerous wind. It is called as a tailwind. Then crosswind. This wind, it is shown in the figure here. It is coming in a perpendicular direction or at some angle to the aircraft. This is called as a crosswind component. It makes an angle with the direction of an aircraft movement. If this component is more, then the aircraft has to be is very difficult to safely land. So it should not be more than 25 km per hour. So from our engineering point of view, this headwind is very good and it supports us. This tailwind is very dangerous and crosswind should not be greater than 25 km per hour. If it is more than that, it becomes a dangerous one. See here, we have to orient the runway in the direction of wind. See here, this is the tailwind. It is very bad. Headwind will help us to take off the aircraft and also for landing the vehicle in a safer distance. And crosswind, which is at V sine theta. This is also dangerous when it exceeds 25 km per hour. In this direction, we have to orient our runway. So, how about the wind coverage? It is a percentage time in an year during which the crosswind components remains within the limit. Okay, this our agency recommends a minimum wind coverage is only 95%. Then what is a calm period? When the wind intensity is very low, that is 100 minus the wind coverage. Wind coverage is almost 95%. Okay, so 100 minus 95, you will get 5%. Then 5% will be the calm period. So all these contents I have taken from the slide share. I have given it in the reference. Thank you.